Hi and welcome to Desktop Commando's Guide to Using Smart Alarms and Smart Switches Continued. Today I'm going to be talking about intruder alarms and how to detect people breaching walls in your bases. Right, as you can see the following setup. I got this off Rust Quick Electric. It was about maybe 2 years old and it was first initially how to set off an alarm using the RF broadcaster. But now we've got the companion app for Rust Plus. I've connected to the alarm instead. So, as you can see, power will come in, out and around, and it'll go into the XOR switch, which when it has two lots of power going through it, will not transmit. However, if you take out one of the power options, for example this switch, it will send off a signal, as you can see just then. So switch this back off. So how would this work for an alarm? Okay, well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you. I'm going to switch off here. What I'm going to do is instead of the switches up here, I'm going to connect it to these switches placed along the wall. And switch them on. Now they're connected, as you can see, it will be powered down. Any point in the time that anybody comes along, jumps the fence, tampers with them, or even blows a hole in the wall, then the alarm's going to get set off again, and there you go. So when power's running through it, switches off, any interruption, and it will fire a message. Okay, we're going to move on to the next one, which is using it within honeycombing, as you can see here. So again, what has to be is someone firing rockets or coming through from the other side interrupts honeycombing, and we get a message sent. So all you have to do is hide away, and it's easy if you get the wires and bring them around, so even from the outside or inside nobody has a clue what's going on. Cool. Right, the other thing I have kind of noticed is if the power supply is interrupted, you get a very quick message sent, as you can see. But as you can see from the message, it sends the wrong type of message. So the only way that you'll be able to detect is if the honeycombing is still going or not. So to this degree, I thought, as this bug shows you the power suddenly flash, what if we actually add the power straight in? So to this detection, it doesn't really matter if you switch this on and off, this is actually sending a power signal through. So how do you find out if your base is still receiving power, your alarm system? This is it. It'll be constantly transmitting to your app. Right, moving around to the same degree. What I realized was, how about if we could connect the power going straight in? So I tried playing with it here to see, can this go from your power straight into a connection, and can it then go into there? No, it can't. The only way it got to go directly is in through root controllers. So you can jerry-rig your root controllers up and down the place, and then before it goes into whichever device, batteries and things like that, then it will send. Okay. Right. In the same way, you can jerry-rig it up through your solar panels. Solar panels, in through, and straight away. So, here we go. So, the whole point of this is, do you want to know if someone's taking out your power supply? Breaking these is fair enough. People standing on top of your bases, smashing up your solar panels and things. What I would suggest with this one is doing the same sort of thing, but what they're actually going to do is, I call it more of a day and night detector. So if you edit the message, click in here, as you can see, put it like that, you know, day on, night off, if you get what I mean.